How are you now?
Fine. I'm better. Very, very thank you for your hospitality. I really appreciate. And I must say, you're a very nice person. Yes.
Very nice person. It's just that if it's only me, I would not like you to go. But what would I do? I have to let you go.
Yeah.
And I would advise you, as a very good friend of mine, that you should be careful. I don't know you're only me. The doctor said 2-3 days you should stay. Well, you have to be there. So, alright. So, hope you are going to see next time.
Sure, definitely. Maybe I'll drop my contact and I'll book an appointment to meet somewhere.
Somewhere.
Well, you really, really have to be very, very careful because my presence around is dangerous.
Oh, I'll leave you to talk.
We'll still find a way. We'll see, for sure. Thank you very, very much. Once again, I'm Zubi. Thank you, ma'am. Bye-bye. See you some other time. Guy, where are you there? I did ask to be with you. Okay. Ma koiba.
You have body roll out.
Hey, babe, I'm listening at the moment. I think it will be long and so I want to have
good afternoon, sir. Yes, sir. Honestly, I didn't see that guy. Like, I've only gone around to check for him, but it seems nobody knows him in this hood, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But, sir, I promise I will fish him out. I promise. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
They say I'm young, but my purpose is the inspiration of a nation. Innovation, till I change the talk into a conversation. I'm like a doctor and my patients are anxiously waiting, healing all the hating, that faking in the paper chasing. It's hard to live up to these expectations that I'm facing, and gain the admiration of an older generation. That's why I'm pacing back and forth, contemplating, meditating, how to use what I've been taught as a positive force.
You're really tired.
How are you?
I'm fine.
You look good.
Thank you.
I must really say a very big thank you for the other day. I really appreciate.
Okay, so you really look stressed and worried. What's up?
Yeah, I look stressed, worried, as you can call it, but I must say I'm losing a very good amount of money.
Huge amount of money.
Very good. I can't even think of how I lost the money. I don't know the person in question, the person in possession of the money.
So, before you lose such amount of money, you're supposed to get into a business, right? So, what kind of business are you into?
Yeah, not really
into
a business.
Does this have to do with the incident that happened with your accident?
I can't really tell. The only story I can tell about this money is I was going to town. I saw a briefcase in a vehicle I was into and I picked it. On my way going with it, I found out people in the vehicle were following me. When I fastened my step, I noticed they were also fastening their step. And I don't know if they were after me or the briefcase.
That'd be the case. I don't know what kind of business would have resulted to all this mess you've gotten yourself into, but you have to get in touch with the police.
Talking about the police being involved in this case, I don't think it's a good idea because I can't give a statement of this money. Involving the police will just end up in a mess.
Really?
Or finding myself in jail.
So what you're trying to say is, me helping you, I'm also putting my life at risk.
Yes, because definitely the people that shot me, as you said,
oh Jesus,
will definitely be looking for you. They will think you are in possession of the money. They may hurt your life.
It's not really that possible. So I have a lot of connections. I can help to get your money back. Whatever be the case, I have the money to bribe them or buy them off just to get your money for you.
Yeah. Yes,
so how do I come in? Because I really want to help you.
I don't know.
Good evening, ma. Good evening. How to buy an amplifier? Okay, now give me one. Just leave that. Let me carry baby now so you can't get it. Baby! Stop crying. Is it a boy?
Yeah.
Okay, give me one. Baby. Oh, thank you.
My child, my baby.
Please.